So how did the word Hindu actually come about? What is the origin? Many Hindus talk about it as Sanatan Dharma. Can you elaborate on this?
The word Dharma is very important because it is a transition from the word Rita, this is how things work, to the word saying, let us make sense of the forces that operate in the world outside us, as well as the forces that operate within us, our emotions, our drives, our intellect, our linguistic ploys. Let us come to terms with all these faculties we possess and harness them. When you talk about harnessing these forces external as well as forces internal, the word Dharma, that which upholds everything, came about. Then we added the word Sanatan, seeking the resolution of the human condition, which is not just temporary, it should continue forever. The second word must have universality and eternal value. So we added the word Sanatan, and it becomes Sanatan Dharma. The word Dharma is central to Buddhism as well. Buddha called it Dhamma. That means the word Dharma was already visible in his times. The word Hindu has a different background. In ancient India, there was a river in the northwest part called River Sindhu. Sindhu in Sanskrit means vast amount of water. The Persians, they had a difficulty pronouncing the sa sound and had a habit of replacing the sa sound to the ha pronunciation. They looked at the river, so Hindu. He said, no, Sindhu. And they said, no, Hindu. We gave up. So they say people living around this river Sindhu will be called Hindus. The river was called River Hindu. The story didn't stop there. Then the Greeks arrived. They were probably the her. They were like to convert the her to a. So we are now calling the river River Hindu. There's a river Indus. So the name of the river was again transformed from Sindhu, Hindu to Indus. Even today it is called River Indus. The Greeks say the people who live across the river are people of Indoi, and the nation is India. So river produced the name of it, the tradition as well as the country.
That's so fascinating. When we discuss Hinduism as not a religion, not a way of life, how did this transformation take place from Vedic times to current day Hinduism, which is kind of a religion, kind of a way of life, but not really?
The initial part of the Vedas is to focus on forces of nature. But the beauty of our tradition, it continues to evolve. It moved away from focusing just the physical forces to the idea of focusing on our inner nature. This is the real beginning of our tradition. Discovering the essential nature of human beings as something different from what it appears. And part of the Vedas, Aranyaks, contain the throbbing heart of Hinduism called the Upanishads. The Upanishads mostly focus on our essential nature as the spirit, Atman, and the essential nature of the creation as Brahman, and the relationship of Atman with Brahman. How are we linked with the greater reality? That is the deeper vision, the esoteric, principle-oriented Hinduism. This forms the foundation of Hinduism.
You mentioned Kapil Muni as being the key person who changed the way of thinking from forces of nature into more of a spiritual realm for Hinduism. But you also said that you're not sure if he's a historic figure. So how do we know that it was Kapil Muni who created this change if there is no proof of that?
Suppose Kapil Muni is not a real person and somehow this name got caught up through the storytelling and narrative. So what? The ideas are very dynamic. This man is the first person to have recognized a deeper dimension to our being.